on in. Come in, please. Hello? I'm Dan Ryder. Good to meet you, Nick. How are you doing? Let's see here. Why don't you tell me a little bit about yourself?
Currently, I'm a senior at Northeast Hamilton. Next fall, I plan on attending Iowa State University for mechanical or civil engineering. I'm not quite sure yet, but I enjoy using CAD. Right now, in high school, I play all four seasonal sports, so football, basketball, track, baseball. Last year, I went to state for track. I'm also involved with my church. I'm in National Honor Society, Rotary Club. I'm a class officer. I'm a student council, and I'm also a officer for student council.
What do you do with the Rotary Club?
Well, it was an award that they gave us to us last year. So we went to this banquet dinner. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's speak a little bit.
Tell me a little bit about why you are interested in engineering and why mechanical and or civil.
Well, both my parents are engineers. Mm-hmm. My brother just graduated from Iowa State and lives in Minneapolis and works for Thomson Reuters. He's a software engineer. My sister currently goes to Iowa for biomedical engineering. Yeah, I know.
I'm sorry, I didn't mean to wince like that.
And my sophomore year, Northeast Hamilton started sharing with Webster City because our school is too small for electives. And one of the elective classes I took was it's Project Lead the Way, which is an engineering class. And it was called Intro to Engineering and Design. And there we used this program called Inventor. And that's where I learned about CAD, and I really enjoyed it. So that got me thinking about mechanical engineering.
You've done some AutoCAD in Inventor?
Yes.
What have you designed using that?
We did a lot of projects my sophomore year. We had packets just of normal objects with dimensions that we had to make. And then we did like a 3x3 cube with smaller cubes, and then we made it into an actual cube on Inventor. And then we had to make it a physical thing. So it was a 3x3 cube, and then we glued it into different parts, and then we had to put it together so it was a puzzle cube. We also made... We had to pick an object, and we had to go backwards in the process of making an object. So I chose a flashlight, so we had to take it apart, dimension it, and then we had to make it on Inventor.
Reverse engineering.
Okay. We also made a train on Inventor.
What kind of train?
It was like a toy train, just a basic toy train with the wheels were able to move, though.
Oh, okay. It was electric power, or
no? It had no power.
Okay. Just the shell and the mechanisms, that type of thing. Okay. Have you worked with any projects as a team?
One of our last projects was we were in a group, and we had to. There's different situations, and ours was we had to make a classroom object. So pretty much we made a classroom organizer that could hold folders, and it had drawers that you could pull out to put papers or whatever you wanted, and you could also hold pencils. So we had to design it ourselves and put in the dimensions and then make it on in there.
How many people were on the team?
Three.
And did you have, how did you split up the responsibilities?
Well, this is mostly a group effort, so like, we pretty much all talked about the same thing at once. But then, the way it was split up was the parts we had designed. So, two walls, and then we had someone design the drawers. And we pretty much just took turns drawing the outline inventor. And then we had to put it all together. Because this on inventor, there's different folders that you can then put together. And then...
What was the material you made from?
PCP plastic. Basic plastic.
Okay. How did you determine the properties of why did you choose that material? material and how did you determine the property?
I don't quite remember because it was my sophomore year, but I'm pretty sure we had a paper with a list of materials that we should use. So we had to like research the material. It's just one that we chose for some reason.
Have you worked on any other projects, a team project since then?
Well, I also take another project lead away class this year. I was supposed to take two, but principals of engineering, the teacher left and went to Wisconsin, so that class was not available anymore. But I take civil engineering and use Revit for that class. And we just did a group project where we only have 7 kids in the class, and so we all worked as a group, and we had to pick different roles. I was a construction engineer, and there was a situation where it was made up, and this lady just died, and she, in her will, she gave a 100 square acre land to the city to make it into a like suburb for, I think it was like 100 homes or something like that, and they had to also have a building for health, and to also have a restaurant. And so we had to all work together to design what that 100 acres would look like. And so we decided to make an apartment building with restaurants underneath. And then across
how did you come to that decision?
Apartment building actually was my idea, and then I explained why. Because 100 acres is not much at all for 150 homes. So the way I thought we could get 150 homes is by making an apartment building so we could have different stories. Then we had a U-shaped street go through that suburb, and on the other side of the street was the restaurant. We also had to have a shopping area, so we had like Walgreens or something.
That was the parameters that was given to you, or you decided on that? Team decided on that?
In the will, we had to go by the lady's will.
Okay.
And so there was restriction on that and what she wanted, so we tried to do the best we could to make her once possible.
Stay with the intent of the will.
Okay.
You originally said that you were split between civil engineer and mechanical engineer. Have your project lead the way experiences helped you with that decision?
Yes. Well, after my sophomore year, I was definitely leaning towards mechanical because that's the only class I had. But now my senior year, because I don't have principles in engineering, which is probably, it's more mechanical.
Mm-hmm.
But now I only take civil. And so I'm more used to that now. So.
And what was the software?
I know I should
Revit.
Revit.
And in the future, where do you see yourself?
Like what time period?
5 years down the road.
5 years, so right after college.
Yeah.
Well, at Iowa State, I might join the Air Force ROTC, so hopefully I will still be with them, and looking for a mechanical or civil engineer
job. Do you know, if you do ROTC, Air Force ROTC, do you know what kind of jobs there are for mechanical and or civil engineer in the Air Force?
Not quite.
Okay. How's your eyesight?
Good.
You don't have a correction? Would you ever think of becoming a pilot?
I have, but it would take a lot of experience in order to learn how to fly.
That would teach you. Especially if you're a mechanical engineer. Well, even a civil engineer. Half of becoming a pilot is engineering. So. When you were working with in your team, what was your biggest challenge or biggest couple of challenges working with other students or other engineers?
When I'm in a group, I like to take the lead role, usually. So the difficulty would probably be deciding what others in my group should be doing, so splitting up the roles.
Okay. Do you have any questions for me as an engineer?
Where do you see VanTech in 5 years?
Where do I see VanTech in 5 years? That's a good question. You know, this whole area has had a real difficult last 5 years. VanTech has come out of Electrolux was the major customer of VanTech, but we've replaced some of that, not all of it, not nearly all of it. And you know, there's been other suppliers to Electrolux, local suppliers that have completely shut down. And right now we're doing fairly well, and I think that there'll be other customers that VanTech will need to pick up. One problem VanTech has right now is we can't find enough operators and some of the skilled people too, the people who do the tool maintenance and facility maintenance. So it'll be interesting what happens. I think VanTech, you know, we've survived this long. I think we'll probably be a little bigger, a little larger employer than so we'll probably be 50% more employees in 5 years. But like I say, the VanTech got hit kind of with a double whammy of that Electrolux shut down, and then on top of that there was the Great Recession, and so it was difficult there for a little while, but it'll be here. And you know, now with the fish farm, I'm not sure how that'll affect us, but we'll be here. Any other questions?
Not.
Anything about Iowa State? It's been a long time, but I was there. All righty. Well, thanks.
Round of applause.